Okay, this is Clark Hagens on May 7, I believe it is, 2023, Sunday. And every day here where I live, pretty much, I vomit from some medical condition, either nervousness or I don't know what it is, but here's sometimes it's just a little bit of vomit. Like today, it's just like a little bit of vomit. It seemed like a lot, you know. But this was today's vomit. Now, I think it's because they make me nervous here. I always lock myself in my room, call police. There's two people here that bug me. The guy, Norman Johnson, he only comes around about once a month, or he rarely comes here, the guy, Norman. I don't have a lot of trouble with him, but when he does come here, he makes a lot of trouble. He videotapes my wife. He walks around my house, basically making me vomit like that because I get all nervous. He yells at my wife. He yells at me. He tapes eviction notices to my door while he does not own the house. He's nothing here. He can't evict me. Only the lady Yolanda, who's 87 years old, who is my wife's mother. And me and Yolanda get along good. Now, there is another person here, Valita's sister, named Wanji. And she walks around intimidating me, yelling at me. On a couple occasions, she's chased me into my room. And one occasion, I fell down, hurt my knee. The other one, she hit me on the head with like some little object in her hand. In my room, she actually chased me into my room where I was running backwards, falling backwards, and she came at me, punched me on the head. So she's only punched me one time, and that was about, I don't know, a year or so ago. It was a while ago. But every time these people bug me, I run in my room and I call the police. And one of the reasons is I have a heart condition. My heart beats fast. I get all dizzy. My heart beats erratic. And I vomit a lot. And, you know, I do have skin cancer where I get all these surgeries, but I don't think the skin cancer, I don't think is affected by them bugging me where I live here with my wife. And my wife will back me up 100% of all the things I say here. I don't do anything to these people. In fact, I do the dishes and pretty much I just go in my room and vomit and puke like that. Right here on the Clark the Shark Show, 1-800-449-8255. This is Clark the Shark Hagens. Where I live, I'm a virtual prisoner. I'm 58 years old. They threw no birthday for me here last week. And I'm very nice to these people. I don't even do anything bad to them or anything. I don't intimidate anyone. I'm too sick, you guys. I got cancer that's all over me. I've had 8 surgeries. Where they've removed cancerous moles. And now the doctors tell me, well, we've got most of them, but you might still have cancer floating in your blood. And they've never really been clear. Is it basal cell? Is it squamous cell? Or is it malignant melanoma? Because the thing on the back of my left leg looked like malignant melanoma. It was purple. It was blue. It even had a little part of it that was black. And they removed it. And they never really were clear on what type of cancer that they removed on the back of my left leg. But it was the size of a golf ball, and it was poking out, and it was causing me not to be able to walk well, and it was super painful. And then right after they removed the golf ball-sized tumor slash mole on the back of my left calf, on my leg, my leg hurt for like 8 months where I was just taking Tylenol. I wasn't taking any hardcore pain meds because I don't do that. But a couple of times I did take Vicodin, you know, because the pain was so bad. But, you know, mainly I just took aspirin, Tylenol, Motrin, you know, that sort of thing. Acetaminophen. What's that other one? Oh, Aleve. Just any of those over the counter. I was taking those for like 8 months. And, you know, nowadays the thing on the back of my left leg feels better right here on the Clark the Shark Show. So anyway, basically what happens here is where I live, there are two people who intimidate me, harass me, trying to get me to move. And they make me so sick that I vomit virtually every day. But though I can't prove that I vomit because of them, I think, you know, the nervous condition that they're causing me may be contributing to me vomiting. I mean, today, there's only a little bit of vomit. And usually, you know, when I puke, it's like this yellow or brownish beige stuff. It looks like it's mainly water or liquid. So I don't really throw up food. Sometimes I do throw up food. But whatever it is, you guys, I vomit and throw up here. And where I live, and it could be connected to the cancer. I don't know. I think it is, but maybe not. And then I also have a heart condition that I've had pretty much all my life, because I was born with Bell's palsy, where the whole left side of my body was paralyzed, and particularly my left side of my face and my left ear rings. And, you know, my left eye needed 3 surgeries, and my left ear needed a surgery. So I was born with this Bell's palsy disease in 1965, and then in 1968, 69, 70, 71, and 72, I had all these surgeries done. You know, probably just AMA nonsense that I didn't even need. I don't know. I was only 4, 5, 6, 7 years old, but my mom and dad had me do all these surgeries that I remember. And the ones on my eye sucked because I had things over my eye, my left eye, when I was a kid. I remember, you know, you get dirt in it or something. You're a little kid, you know, you want to go play. And I remember I couldn't or something. And they had a thing over my left ear too, you know, just probably just bullshit, nonsense, needless surgeries that the AMA did to me. But who knows? Maybe they were necessary. And the doctors were right, and I really did need those surgeries when I was a little kid because of the Bell's palsy. There's a good chance I really did need those surgeries. But, you know, who will never know now. I'm 58, and it's 2023. That's the year, and the month is May, and the day is May 7, 2023. Today, Sunday. Me, Clark the Shark. I'm right here telling you guys about how I live at 1637 West 126th Street, and I vomit every day here. I'm sick, probably from the way they treat me here, the way they yell at me, intimidate me. The one lady threatens me. The guy Norman does not threaten me. He just yells at me and intimidates me, and sometimes he calls the police on me after I run in my room. But you can be sure I call the police on this guy all the time. Me, Clark the Shark, I've called the cops on Norman about 15 times, and I've called him on Wanji, oh, probably about 7 or 8 times. So I don't know why they're calling him on me, because all I do is run in my room and lock my door and call the police, or just run in my room and stay to myself like the police advised me to do. Now, before you guys start saying, "Oh, you're such a wuss, Clark, why don't you go out there and man up and do something about it?" And I'm like, no, because me, Clark the Shark, I don't do that. Especially now that I, you know, I'm sick and throwing up, I have a bad heart, and I have skin cancer with all these surgeries. Now, it's not a good idea for me to man up. I just run away. I go in my room and I call the cops when people bug me. Because who knows, if someone punches me, I could like bleed really bad, you know, from the skin cancer or something like that. So I have an absolute policy where I do not fight back. I run in my room and I call the cops. When you're 58 years old, I would advise all of you to do that too, just like me, Clark the Shark. It's not a good idea to man up, you know, put up your dukes and say you're going to go fight somebody. That's a stupid thing to do when you're almost 60 years old, so don't do that. It's a dumbass move, and plus, you know, someone could pull out a weapon or something like that, and you don't want that. So your best policy is do as I do, Clark the Shark, and call police. And I call the Athens, Los Angeles sheriffs, who reside at the corner of Imperial and Normandy Avenue. And I live here at this property with my wife, Valida, who I have been married to since January of 2006. So me and Valida have been married a long time here, people. And I have a right to be with my wife at this house, and I don't bother anyone. And I guess now the one guy, Norman, got a restraining order on me where he made up all these false lies. And he wrote it all down like an idiot and perjured himself in a restraining order. Oh, that's real genius, Norman. And then I'm going to tell any of you who back him up, you're perjuring yourselves too. You're breaking the law and committing a crime when you file a false police report, which to the best of my knowledge, they have not done against me. Or if you file a false restraining order, which they have done, and what's going to happen is the judge is just going to hear my wife and my witnesses, and then the judge is just going to toss it out of court and say, you guys are just bugging this white dude who lives at your house. And oh, by the way, I'm the only white person in this virtually all black neighborhood where I live. So it could be racism. It could be they just don't like white people, or some of them don't, you know, I'm not saying all of them, but maybe some of them don't like whitey and they want me out of here. That's right. Me, Clark the Shark at 1-800-449-8255 on the Clark the Shark Show. Imagine that. Me, the guy that wrote the white black song. You know, no more whites, no more blacks. Let's all just get along kind of thing. Me, Clark the Shark, they're actually racist against me, I perceive anyway, or I suspect. And they are intimidating and bothering me day to day, making me vomit, throw up. You got, here is the puke. Here is the puke from today. And I do this every day here. This is real small for me. Usually, you guys, I'm not kidding. This bucket is like full of puke, you guys. This bucket here that I keep in my room by my bed. You know, it could be, you guys, because of the cancer that I got. I don't think so, though. But who knows? Doctors have told me you can vomit if you got skin cancer. But I don't know, you know. If it's just basal cell carcinoma or squamous cell, I don't see why that would make me vomit. You know, our president, Joe Biden, has basal cell. Now, if Joe Biden had malignant melanoma, he would have to quit being president and go into chemo. And so my doctors have been kind of unclear with me as to whether I have malignant melanoma. They've never really told me concretely that I do or don't have that. But the thing on the back of my left leg was purple and blue. And black. It had a little area in it that was black. On the back of my left calf, golf ball sized mole slash tumor. And I worked as a swimming pool cleaner for about 25 years down in San Diego for Tom Sweeney Community Pool Service and other pool companies, John Kohler, Walt at A to Z Pool in Torrance, and then myself, Clark the Shark, Hagen's Abracadabra Pool, where many of my customers in San Diego did not pay me, and I would take them to court, and I would sue them, and then they would pay me. So isn't that nice? Me, Clark the Shark, I would clean your pool, Carlsbad, Vista, Oceanside, Fallbrook, San Marcos, you know, Del Mar, Solana Beach, San Diego. Me, Clark the Shark, I would clean their pools, and many of these San Diego people over the years, not only would they not pay me, but they would come to the court and lie to the judge, and then the judge would say, dude, you're lying. This guy, Clark, has receipts. He was your pool guy, Clark the Shark. Hagen's was your pool guy, and then the judge would order them to pay me. And I think out of like, I don't know, I think it was like 48 people that I sued, I think only one of them didn't have to pay me because they were a senior citizen and they were too old or something. Hey, kind of like me, Clark the Shark. I think back in like 2007 or 2004, something, I don't remember, but an old guy who didn't pay me, some rich old fart that lived in La Jolla, San Diego, he owed me like $1,300 for pool service, monthly pool service. And I also, you know, did a couple filter cleans in there. You know, some late fees. You know, my late fees weren't that big when I would charge people late fees. And so the judge let that one guy slide because he was like 92 years old. He's even older than me, Clark the Shark, right here at 1-800-449-8255. And with that guy, I was like, oh, well, whatever, you know. And I don't think that guy ever paid me. Maybe he did and I forgot, but virtually all the people that I sue always pay me. And anyone who I sue in court, sometimes I win without even witnesses. you guys, when Clark the Shark goes to court with you, you're in big trouble. And usually I don't even have a lawyer because the judge listens to me, Clark the Shark, at 1-800-449-8255. And in the old days, you know, I forgot what I tell them. But today I'm going to show them this video. If they let me, they probably won't in court. But I'm going to show them the video where I vomit. And I'm going to show them my wife backing me up where they say they persecute and bug me, call me names, call me a honky, white ass, mother effa. And yeah, dude, I actually live with racism. Isn't it ironic that me, Clark the Shark Higgins, who wrote the White Black song, you know, me, Clark the Shark, Greenhouse Effect, it's so ironic and weird that I actually live with racism here in my house. Of course, you all out there know that I'm married to a black lady named Valita, and her family apparently don't like me because I'm white. Maybe some of them like me. Maybe some of them don't. I don't know. But I would say in general, overall, taken as a whole, not only does Valita's family not like me, but all the black people in this neighborhood where I live on 126th Street, every one of them don't like me. They don't talk to me. They don't say hi to me. I wave to them. They don't wave back to me. You know, all these black people are always complaining about racism, and they hardly can ever get it on video. But me, Clark the Shark, it's so ironic and weird that I actually live with this right here on 126th Street where I live with my wife, Valita. And the guy, Tom Sweeney, fired me from my pool job that became most of my income down in San Diego. So I lost my apartment at Sycamore Ridge in Vista, you know, with that lady, Robin, in the front desk there that all the people in the apartment just think the lady's a, you know, real piece of work. Well, that lady evicted me and my wife, Valita. So we had no money. I'd no longer work for Sweeney as a pool guy. I gave up on doing abracadabra because so many people wouldn't pay me. And then I ended up being told by a doctor over time, yeah, Clark, you got cancer. Don't go in the sun anymore. And the doctors, some of the doctors in San Diego and the ones up here in Los Angeles, in El Segundo and in Los Angeles, they all said, Clark, stay out of the sun. Your top minutes in the sun now are like 5 to 8 minutes. That's it. Don't even drive your car in the sun now because you got skin cancer all over you, Clark. Right here on the Clark the Shark Show, 1-800-449-8255. So I, Clark Higgins from the Greenhouse Effect, have become a virtual prisoner in my own home here where I live with my wife. They make it so I can't walk in the kitchen. They intimidate me. They call me names. They bug me. They harass me. They tape notes on my door. They tape notes around my house. So usually I just stay in my room and vomit like this right there, you guys. Sometimes I go outside. I go to my doctor or I go just somewhere to get away from these people. Some of the people here actually like me. There's maybe 3 or 4 nice souls who are cool. Valita's brother Vesta is cool. And there's a guy named Anthony. He's totally cool to me. And there's a guy named Darion. He's totally cool to me. Now, all of these people used to be cool to me back when I owned a house and I worked for Sweeney or, you know, I worked for Abracadabra Pool and Spa, swimming pools where I made all this money. I had big houses. But I notice, isn't it strange how suddenly when Clark the Shark is old, they don't like me anymore. I no longer have a house of my own or a vehicle. I can't work a job. I'm on SSDI now. That attorney Bill Latour and another attorney named Jonathan Bryan got me, you know, state fund, workers' comp settlements and SSDI monthly payments, these two attorneys. And the judge said, yeah, Clark, he does have skin cancer. He does have bad knees. He does vomit, you know, all that. And so they gave me SSDI. So basically the people here, or at least 2 people, maybe 3, I'm not sure, but they're trying to badger a guy out of a house who's 58 years old, who has cancer and who vomits every day. And not only that, they intimidate me, harass me, bug me. And I do nothing to them. All I do is run in the room and call the police and lock the door, which is the exact advice my attorneys Bill Latour, all the people at his office told me to do that. And the police at the corner of Imperial and Normandy at the police station, the sheriff's Los Angeles Athens division, they told me, Clark Higgins, you go in your room, lock the door, and if you have any trouble, call us. And that is exactly what I do. I don't ever call anyone names. I don't ever accost or run up on anyone. I always run away. And you know what? You guys in the South Bay know me, Clark the Shark, not known to be a tough guy or a fighter. I'm not a guy who mans up. I usually do run away because I'm a lover, baby, not a fighter. I write songs and I'm Clark the Shark, you know, the drummer, the great drummer from the Greenhouse Effect and the South Bay, Redondo Beach, Torrance, Hermosa Beach. I got to look after my hands, baby, my drumming and my guitar playing and my songwriting. I don't have time to fight with people. I usually do run away and call the police. You know, like when my brother Bert, my brother Doug, my brother Jeff, or someone bugs me, I usually call the police. And I've been doing this since I was like, 6 and 7 years old, back in, you know, 1971, 72, 73, at 251 Paseo de Gracia, Redondo Beach. I've been calling the police on my brothers and saying things like, hey, why doesn't my dad back me up? Because when I was a little kid, I was a really scrawny little kid. You know, I was like 125-pound bleach albino white kid that people picked on. And of course, you know, my three brothers, Bert, Doug, and Jeff, they loved picking on me, Clark the Shark. And so I would often call the police. And I noticed my brother Jeff and Doug were always conveniently gone. And sometimes my brother Doug would even stay away from the house for weeks or even months because the Torrance police were like, if we see that guy, you know, we're going to, you know, arrest him or give him a ticket or something or give him a good talk to leave Clark the Shark alone at 1-800-449-8255. Yeah, the South Bay knows it, dude, you guys. Shark does not man up. And when I got in fights as a little kid at Parkway and Newton, you know, sometimes I was in the wrong, but usually it was justified. It was almost always a bigger kid picking on me, Clark the Shark. And when it wasn't, you know, sometimes there was some little asshole that I would bug. And I admit it, maybe when I was 10 years old or 9 years old, there could have been times where I was just being a douchebag when I was a little kid. But I probably learned that from Doug Higgins and Jeff and Bert and maybe even my dad, too, at 251 Paseo de Gracia, 90277 Redondo Beach, Torrance. But for the most part, me, Clark the Shark, I stay in my room. I run away. I call the police. I scream, leave me alone. And I vomit like this. And I puke. All alone in my room with not many friends. And who knows, maybe it was because I was born with Bell's palsy, that disease. You know, my dad was at Camp Lejeune, you know, and got all sick. And all my life, my dad, Gary Higgins, was sick. And then he died of multiple myeloma in 2010. And who knows, you guys, maybe I, Clark the Shark, vomit like this because of the Bell's palsy. You know, it could be the skin cancer. It could be because my heart is bad. You know, I've always had a bad heart. I've been to many doctors over my heart since I was a child. That could be a reason why I often run away too and can't fight or don't fight because of my bad heart. And I'm literally afraid I could have a heart attack. And the teachers at Parkway, Newton, and South all knew this. And I went to the doctor for my heart over the years so many times. And we could never figure out what is wrong with Clark's heart. But it probably had something to do with the Bell's palsy that I was born with. And I had, you know, like four surgeries for my ears and eyes back when I was a kid. Right here on the Clark the Shark Show. At 1-800-449-8255, or it's another day of vomiting, loneliness, and being persecuted and harassed by Clark the Shark Higgins, who's 58, now almost a senior citizen. I'm going to retire in about 4 years when I'm 62, but retire from what? I can't work. I got cancer. I got a heart problem. I'm very sick. I stay in this room most of the time. I can't go in the sun. Okay, you guys are listening to everything. And I Clark the Shark, right now, under penalty of perjury in a courtroom, I have my right hand raised and I am telling the whole truth and nothing but the truth. I swear to God right now on this video, and you can talk to people in Torrance in the South Bay. They'd be like, yeah, Clark the Shark never played baseball, never played soccer, never played any sports hardly. You know, later on when I grew up a little older, I played some hockey. But I think it was because my mom was like, you know, Clark the Shark, we're not really telling him everything that's wrong with him. But he pukes, and he was born with Bell's palsy. He's got a bad heart, you know. And all my life I've been puking, even before I lived here. And I just thought puking and vomiting was normal part of life. Me, Clark the Shark. But it's not. Other people tell me, they're like, no, Shark, I don't puke and vomit all the time. And I'm like, really? Doesn't everyone puke and vomit all the time? And people are like, no, Sharky, we don't puke and we don't vomit like you. At 1-800-449-8255 on the Clark the Shark Show. But let me tell you, you guys, I puke and I vomit still to this very day at age 58. And most of the time I stay away from people. I don't go to bars. I don't go to Disneyland. I don't go around people. The only time I do is when I have to go to Vons or Stater Brothers or shopping at Target or Walmart. And usually when I do, you know, there's some asshole messing with me, but I don't do anything back. I just get in my car, put my groceries in, and I leave. And, you know, I think you guys in the South Bay know this. Of course, my wife, Valita, she knows this, you guys. Clark the Shark does not get in confrontations. You know me, I'm a Taurus, baby. April 27th, last week. Non-confrontational, hardworking, reliable, conservative, makes money, keeps to himself, a loner, funny, sense of humor, but mainly keeps to himself. All the things that still are and or used to be Clark the Shark, right here on the Clark the Shark Show. Very boring guy, not a lot of friends, and people in the South Bay know it. You know, there's no point in hanging out with Clark the Shark because all he does is vomit, you know, or something, or complain that he's sick. You can't go to have any fun with Shark, because how can you have fun with a guy who vomits all the time, who's always sick with cancer or a heart problem or has to stop and rest all the time and shit like that? Who would want to hang out with a person like that? Neither would I, right here on the Clark the Shark Show. Me, Clark the Sharky, baby. But I do play music, drumming, guitar, singing. And I was in the Greenhouse Effect, you guys. And you guys do like to watch my videos, especially the South Bay, but all over the country. And, you know, YouTube banned all my videos pretty much. I only have one channel left. But you guys in America and in England and Ireland and South Africa and Australia, white-speaking, I mean, English-speaking white countries love to watch Clark the Shark. But so, too, does Poland, Russia, Italy, you know, Ukraine, Czechoslovakia, Turkey, and countries like those. They like to watch Clark the Shark. So does Brazil and Mexico. All over the world, they like to watch Clark the Shark and the Greenhouse Effect. And people even email me and tell me so. They write me all these kind emails like, you're really talented and we love your music. We love your singing voice and your songwriting especially. They don't really say they love my drumming. That's really weird, because in the South Bay, everyone's always reminding me what a great drummer I was or I am, or, you know, everyone always says that in the South Bay. But all around the world, they don't really say that. They say, we love your guitar, we love your singing, we love your songwriting. And there's a guy named Jeff Snow at Rock City Productions in Worcester, Massachusetts, or Worcester, however you pronounce it. He's a big fan of the Greenhouse Effect, Jeff Snow. Talk to him if you want to know the truth about me and my music, but a lot of you out there already do, right here on the fabulous, amazing Clark the Shark Show, where I vomit. Pretty much that's my life, you guys. I puke, I have no friends, and I puke, and my wife looks out for me. She's real cool. Even she isn't the coolest, but she's all right. And right here on the Clark the Shark Show, and the people where I live, most of them are not too nice to Shark. But then again, my entire life, most of the people are not too nice to Clark the Shark, because they know I vomit. And nobody wants to hang out with someone who throws up and vomits every day. So they're pretty smart not to hang out with me. I'm probably someone you don't want to hang out with, Clark the Shark. but I'm a cool guy on the internet to watch, you know, music videos from afar. You can sit there at home and gawk and go, oh, look at Sharky. So funny and witty. And he's a great performer, a great songwriter. He's great on talk radio. He's got these artistic skills. But whenever Shark lives somewhere, someone like that lady Cherie, or that lady Grace, or some lady, wherever I live, there's always a lady trying to persecute me out of the house, calling the cops on me. And usually I'm just a guy sitting in my room all alone, not bothering anyone. Very rarely does Shark go anywhere with anyone, or step outside my world. I'm usually too busy vomiting, you guys, to hang out with people. But usually wherever I live, there's a lady or a guy trying to get a restraining order or trying to always call the cops on a guy who just sits in his room and doesn't even bug anyone. And if someone was always bugging all of you out there, I think you guys might yell too and try to take up for yourself. If someone was always bugging you the way they bug and harass and bother Clark the Shark right here on the Clark the Shark Show, 1-800-449-8255, where I vomit. That's what I do for a living, you guys. I puke, vomit, my heart hurts, I get headaches, and I have skin cancer. Those are pretty much my occupations now, you guys. And people outside my door tape things to my door saying, you got a 3-day notice, you got a 30-day notice, you got a 1-week notice, you know, you got a 10-day notice, you got a 7-day notice to leave. Or, you know, you're making noise, Clark, you got to leave. And they actually pound on my door wherever I live. They tape things to my door. And when I dare walk out to make a cup of coffee, they accost me. They get in my face, yell at me. Sometimes they even stick a camera in my face while I'm making coffee or doing the dishes or keeping to myself. I'm not perfect, you guys, and none of you are either. We're all here on this earth matrix, whatever this is. And I'm sure there's some of you out there that are like Clark the Shark. And then there are those of you that are like, well, Shark, I'm just going to man up. I ain't like you. I don't run away, boy. I'm man up like Doug Higgins, USMC, baby. Yeah, you guys keep manning up and see where that takes you. You know, that might impress the ladies and the girls, but that don't impress a lawyer or the police officers right here on the Clark the Shark Show at 1-800-449-8255. So I tell all of you, it's probably better to not man up. It's better to vomit and stay in a room all day by yourself and call the police. Believe it or not, just like me, Clark the Shark, who vomits for a living. You know, I had Bell's palsy. I probably still have Bell's palsy from 1965 when I was born at Harbor General Hospital on Carson Street in Torrance. That day, I came into the world with Bell's palsy, and they had to operate on my eyes, ears, maybe even my nose. I don't remember. They did so many surgeries on me at that hospital, Harbor General, now known as County UCLA Hospital. In Harbor City. I guess it's Harbor City, not Torrance. But anyway, that's my occupation, you guys. I am lonely. I am alone, and I vomit. And people bug me and make fun of me, call me names, call me honky, white-ass cracker. And before that in the South Bay, you know, I won't say the names they called me. And they know, you know, I'm just a guy who I ain't gonna man up. Dude, I'll call the fucking police or get my lawyer if you come and mess with me, you know, because when you call, you know, when you try to man up, it's a dumb idea because you get in a fight and, you know, you get a black eye and a bloody nose, and the police sometimes will even arrest you. So my advice to you is don't do that, you guys. Call the cops, go in your house and vomit like Clark the Shark at 1-800-449-8255, because that's what I do right here on the Clark the Shark Show. And that's practically all I ever do. Because I got cancer, and I got a bad heart, and I was born with Bell's palsy, but I still clean pools for 30 years. I bought 3 houses. I took care of my wife. Me and my wife lived independent for a long time. From 1998 all the way till 2019, I took care of my wife. So that's a responsible guy. Clark the Shark. I lived on Columbus Circle or Columbus Way in Vista. Really nice neighborhood where I bought a big old gigantic house. I also made money with Greenhouse Effect on the internet, you guys, and you all know that too. And, you know, made some money with crypto and things like that. You know, that's what Sharky does. But today, now, I'm still making money somewhere. you guys, but I'm too busy vomiting, bro, and having a bad heart and a nervous condition all the time. 1-800-449-8255, you guys. That's the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So help me God, right here on the Clark the Shark Show. And I'm really not a bad guy. If you hang out with me, which is rare, if anyone does, they discover Clark's really a nice person. And he's really cool. You know, I may not be one of those manly men who work out at 24 Fitness or lift weights or break bricks with their head or break bricks with their, you know, karate chop a brick with your knee or your elbow, or one of those NHL guys, you know, like Ryan Reeves or, you know, Bob Probert or, you know, Marty McSorley. I may not be that, you guys, but I'm still worth something. Me, Clark the Shark. Even though I mainly just vomit and have a bad heart, I did 12 days in hospital in 2012 with a bad heart, you guys, because of what my sister Mary did to our family with that attorney up in Torrance. My brother Greg and my sister Mary, what they did to me. I think my heart has never been the same since 2011 and 2012 when I got really sick back then, you guys. I did right before the election in 2012, Romney versus Obama, I was in the hospital for I think 16 nights. I was in Vista, that hospital, Tri-City Memorial in Vista, with a bad heart. They were like, Clark, there's something wrong with your heart and it won't slow down. And I was there for a long ass time, you guys, in that hospital. And the doctor actually came to me one day and he said, you know, you just look really stressed out. Your heart is bad. There's something wrong, but you don't have any clogged arteries, Clark, you know. They're like, your heart just seems nervous and sad or something, you know. Clark the Shark at 1-800-449-8255. But it could be 2012 is much like 2023, where I am alone, persecuted, harassed, and bothered. And I vomit right here, you guys, on the Clark the Shark Show. I puke and I vomit. It looks like urine. It almost looks like I'm throwing up urine, the shit in this bucket, you guys. I mean, that looks like piss. I mean, maybe I got something wrong with my kidneys or my liver and I'm vomiting urine, maybe. I don't know. You guys, I better go to the doctor and check this shit out. That looks like urine. But anyway, I'm just letting you guys know, me, Clark the Shark, in conclusion, I say I keep it to myself, baby. Stay in my room and I call the police if anyone bugs me. I do not accost or intimidate or bother people. I do not do that. And everyone knows that too. People in South Bay are like, that does not sound like the MO of a shark. Anyone accusing Sharky of strangling them or punching them, they don't know Sharky at 1-800-449-8255 because I don't do that. That is not me in any way, shape, or form. I am a mellow dude who sits on, you know, this internet and does the Clark the Shark Show or greenhouse effect music for the most part. That's what I do. I don't bother people or bug people or harass people or intimidate people. I don't do that. I do not bug people. And in fact, I'm actually so nice, it's annoying. You know, the guy down in South, John Kohler, the swimming pool guy, one of the swimming pool repair cleaner guys that I knew, he owned a business in Encinitas. And John Kohler once said, Clark, you're not enough of a dick. That's why all the other pool guys in IPSA don't like you. And I'm like, what? And he's like, you're not enough of a dick. You know, him and his wife, Patricia, at Kohler Pool, you know, pool store, poolsupply.com, they were like, yeah, Clark, you're too nice. Like, I'll never forget Pat Kohler saying, you know, Clark, you're too nice. I haven't heard that just on one or two occasions. I've heard that a lot where people are like, you know, Clark, you got to get a little more aggressive, bro. You're too nice. Imagine that, dude. They say that to me. And that could be why I vomit at 1-800-449-8255 on the Clark the Shark Show. Yeah, that does look like piss. I mean, it's vomit, you guys. It's beige. It looks yellow, but it's actually, it looks like urine. But that's what you might do if you are too nice at 1-800-449-8255, the Clark the Shark Show. And I'm out. Peace.